expensive affair. In this country, it's not easy to run a school without government support. So willy-nilly, you have to accept this system and try to be as cautious as possible in safeguarding your values. Please.
Hazur, my question is about sadaqah. In the Holy Quran, Allah Ta'ala has said in Surah Baqarah, Allazina yunfikuna amwalahum bil-layli wan-nahari sirran wa alaniyatan. On the other hand, sir, in Bible, the teaching is, when you give sadaqah, right hand should not know what left hand is doing. Obviously, there is a bit of contradiction.
Contradiction in what?
In sirran wa alaniyatan, in the Holy Quran.
But there is no contradiction. I don't see any contradiction. What is the contradiction? Tell me.
Siram wa laniyatan. I mean, you should let other people know as well and do it without telling people. There are two different commandments.
Two different things at two different times. Lail wa nahar are two different times. Siram wa alaniya are two different things.
Another small question on the Bible and the Holy Quran, sir. According to the Bible,
yes.
Hazrat Ishaq was sacrificed.
And Ishaq what?
Was sacrificed.
Yes, yes.
And according to the Holy Quran, Hazrat Ismail. Why?
It's not a small question. It requires a very big answer, and that I have already done. In one of my Eid sermons, I suppose, or somewhere else. So, now it's your turn. I think at such speed I will be able to dispose of many questions.
Yes. We'll have to think more.
Yes. Please.
The opponents of the Ahmadiyya movement in Islam accuse us that when we recite the sacred kalima and say Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is the messenger of Allah, we really mean Hazrat Mirza Ghulam Ahmad alaihi salam instead of the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Would Hazur kindly advise us whether any of the opponents ever quoted any reference from the books of the promised Messiah or any writings of the ulema of the movement as an evidence in support of their claim?
Okay, is there any? Fantastic. This question is absolutely fantastic. How could you ask such a question? You know that there can't be any reference whatsoever to this effect. Do you suspect that there could be some writing to this effect?
No. My thing is that if we have a case against anybody and we don't produce any evidence,
yes,
the case is dismissed. So it means
so
that Mirza Ghulam's case is dismissed.
So it's dismissed already.
But they don't accept it yet.
It's up to them. All right. Please, thank you so much for asking. Your turn.
Hazur, one of the ministers in Pakistan government has made a statement, Quran aur Sunnat par taqeeq ka mustaqil idara qaim kiya jaye aur jadeed daur ke taqaze poore hote nazar aaye. And then he said, Quran Majeed ki galat sehatmand muashire mein sahi ijtihad Quran Majeed ki galat taweelon se tahaffuz ka zariya hai. Could you kindly comment on this, please? It's before I ask another question on this.
He's quite right about it.
Well, sir, is there any need for that when we have Hazrat Masih Maud already and we have all the tafsirs of the Holy Quran done by Hazrat Muslim Maud?
Does he believe in those things?
No, I was thinking of writing to him.
Beg pardon?
I was thinking of writing to him and telling him this job is done already.
The person who has spoken on this subject does not believe in Hazrat Masih Maud alayhi salatu wasalam. Yet what he has said is right. There is such need. So why should you contradict him or try to take up the issue with him? It's not proper. If somebody, even if he is an enemy, has spoken the truth, you should agree with him. Yes, please, your question, your turn.
Yeah.
As Hazur had mentioned in several occasions that the ulama had issued fatwas declaring kafir, non-believers, those of the Muslims who did not agree with their views on certain teachings of Islam. Would Hazur kindly guide us whether there were some among the Muslim leaders who raised their voice against these ulama for issuing such fatwas and dividing the Ummat-e-Muslima, the followers of Islam, in different groups?
Yes, from time to time there have been many voices raised, but to no effect, because those voices were also stilled by the louder voices of the ulama declaring themselves kafirs. Allama Iqbal himself raised voice against it, but Deen Mulla fi Sabilillah Fasad, this is his verse, but he himself was declared a kafir. Sir Sayyid Ahmed raised voice. Many other intelligentsia of the Muslim society at various times tried to do it, but their voices were stilled, as I have said, by the louder and coarser voices of the mullah declaring themselves to be them to be kafirs themselves. So this has been going on and on. Your turn, please.
So, Hazur, this is
I have noticed one difference now in you. In the first part of your when you asked questions, say in the first half hour, you used to scratch right side of your head. Now in the second half hour, you have started scratching the left side. Have you stored your questions on the right side and left side? One side is exhausted and another is not yet? Did you do what he did? For the first time he did this. Now after he's exhausted that side, now he starts scratching it.
Thank you. What does history show, what happened at the death of Prophet Hazrat Musa? Was the Khilafat prolonged for 30 years or 1400 years, please? Could you explain?
Until Hazrat Isa alayhi salatu wasalam, his Khilafat continued till the time of Hazrat Isa alayhi salatu wasalam. Your turn now. Do what I want you to do tonight. To exhaust you.
Time is about to finish, otherwise I can continue.
Yes, please, go ahead.
As most of the known prophets belong to the Middle East and the climate of that area is normally warm, would Hazur kindly advise us?
Now please repeat the first part of the sentence.
As most of the known prophets belonged to the Middle East and the climate of that area is normally warm, would Hazur kindly advise us if spirituality has any connection with heat?
I know puberty has some connection with this. Coming of age, puberty has certain connection with the warm climates, that I know. And also, the warmth has spiritual connection as well, there is no doubt. But it does not mean that the prophets have always been sent and only been sent to the warm climates. The known prophets, as you said, perhaps by that you mean the prophets as mentioned in the Holy Quran.
Yes, sir.
But the Holy Quran mentions that there are so many prophets we sent, and in every region we sent prophets, and in every people we sent prophet, in every age we sent prophets. So according to those verses which generally speak of prophets without naming them, it is very clear that thousands of prophets must have come in other places, in other ages. So these prophets, some of them are known to their people, and some of them may have been forgotten by them themselves. And also some of them have been distorted in their concept, in their conception, and they have been raised to the status of godhood. So don't say that these were the only prophets or the